Next episode in this FNC Data Grid video series is about cell content types in the FNC Data Grid. We are going to deal today in this video with what kind of objects you can put into grid cells, the difference between cell types and controls that you can insert into data grid cells. And you can do this at a cell level, but also at column level. And of course, when you insert controls into the FNC data grid, you will be able to interact with these controls. Let's dive into the IDE and have a look in detail at how you can deal with different cell types in the FNC data grid. And here we are in our Delphi 12.2 IDE with a FireMonkey application that we created that contains the FNC data grid. But as you will probably know, the FNC data grid can also be used in a VCL Windows application and also in a WebCore web client application. Today, we are using a FireMonkey application, and that means that we could possibly build this to target macOS, iOS, Android, Linux. But today we will give this video here with a Windows example. We created a new FireMonkey application, dropped the default data grid on the form, and in addition to that, a standard FireMonkey calendar control that we will touch in a moment to see how we have used that in connection with the grid. And the other additional component that we dropped on the form is the FNC bitmap container. The bitmap container is different from an image list that you've probably used many times already, offers some extra flexibility, extra possibilities. One of these is, and I'll open up this bitmap container for you so you can see how you can edit it at design time. Here you can see that PNG images were added to the bitmap container, but you can also add many different graphic types such as SVG, GIF, bitmap, icons, and so on. Other than the image list also is that you can add images with different sizes in the bitmap container. So you're not forced to stick to the same size images. You can add whatever image resources that you need in your application to the bitmap container, bind these bitmap containers to controls, and use the bitmaps or graphics actually in general to or use these graphics in your controls. And this binding is done by the bitmap container property that is also featured on the data grid. Enough talking, let's compile and run this demo. So this is how the demo looks. And for the convenience, I will actually go over the code for this demo alongside with the demo. So let's put both on the screen. And first thing to discuss is how the grid is initialized. So here you can see the form create where the grid is initialized. So what is happening? I'm setting the number of columns I need, the number of rows I need, some column stretching so that all columns nicely fit the available initial grid width, some font settings, but here you can see that I'm initializing the captions here at the top of our grid to the different cell types that we will feature in this demo. And then further on, actually here we are already inserting a first type of cells, the controls that we add into cells, in this case a button. So you can see that we create a button and we add a button click event handler to this created button, and then we actually assign this button to the grid managed objects array property. And this way, as such, we insert buttons in the grid header cells in each column in this grid. When I assign this to managed objects, that means that from that moment on, the grid will manage the lifetime of the button. That means that when the grid is destroyed, for example, that the grid is also responsible of destroying the managed objects that have been added, in this case the buttons. And the button clicked event will be used to control what is happening when I click a button. And I'll do that first with the first column, where I'm adding HTML formatted text. And this is the button clicked event handler. We are retrieving the column from which this button was clicked, and depending on the column number, we are performing different actions. In the first column, for the first button click, we are inserting HTML formatted text. And with that, we have covered a first type of cells that are cells with text that contains HTML tags. And here you can see we are using some coloring of text, underlining of text, setting it to italic, etc. And you can also see that when I call auto size row, that the row of the grid has automatically adapted to the content of the cell, in this case the HTML content, and that of course gives you a lot of flexibility to insert all kinds of nicely formatted text into grid cells. Know that this HTML can also include references to images, so you can also combine text and images in cells this way. Second column, we have a button that inserts checkboxes, and this is the code that is responsible for this in this section. What I'm doing here is called the add data checkbox column, and here you see already a different type of adding controls or types to a cell. You can do that on a cell level, you can do that on a column level, and the add data checkbox column will insert checkboxes bound to data in the grid cell. That's why it is a add data checkbox column. Adds that to all cells in that particular column, and the data here is a boolean that controls the checked state of the checkbox. And you can see that this is set via the cells property, where I'm adding a random boolean value for each cell in the column. When, of course, I click these checkboxes, you can see that the checkbox will change the cell value or the cell data that is bound to the checkbox. Next type of cell that we have in the data grid is the radio button. And we also do this in this demo column-wise with the add data radio button column. So our third column in the grid contains radio buttons. And as this is a radio button, at column level, only one row can have the checked radio button in this column. And it is a data radio button, meaning that the state of the radio button is tied to the cell value. And here you can see that the value changes to true when I click on that particular row on the radio button. Fourth column is a progress bar. We are also inserting that column wise. We could have done the add data progress bar with the specifying the cell, but here we are doing that column wise. So the entire column contains progress bars. It is a data progress bar. That means that the progress bar position is tied to the value of the cell. So same story as the checkbox column and radio button column. Here the progress bar will represent a value between 0 and 100, and we set that also via the cell. The next column that we have for you is the images column. Remember in the introduction the bitmap container. The bitmap container is bound to the grid, and here we insert in all rows of this column a bitmap. And here is the add bitmap call, and you can see that we are referencing here a random image or bitmap from the bitmap container, and I'm also setting some cell with the index, the random bitmap index in this bitmap container that has been added. Okay, and then we have a fifth column, which is the button column, and here we are again doing a column-wise manipulation where we insert the same button for all cells in that column with the text click me. And you can see with the control positions property, the array property that is on cell level, that we can control the position of the control in the cell. And here you can see that we vertically and horizontally align the control centered in every cell where it is added. Now you can wonder, how do we handle this click on the cell? We actually handle every button click in the cell, and that is via an event that is exposed at the grid level, and that is the, here we have it, the on cell button click event. So as we insert a button into the grid, the on cell button click event will be automatically triggered for that known button type added to a cell. And here we can simply, we get the information from which cell the button triggered that click, and we simply show it in a message. Let's move on to the custom control, and here you will recognize the calendar control that was in our form. And when we go to the code where that calendar control was added to the grid, here it is. So what we do is we make the calendar visible because we had set it visible false at startup at the form, because it didn't make sense to show the calendar when it is not shown as a part of a grid cell. So we set it to true, and then by simply assigning the calendar to the controls array property that maps on the cells in the grid, we can make that calendar visible in the grid at that specific cell. We also perform auto sizing both row-wise and column-wise to ensure that the size of the cell will nicely fit that calendar added to the cell. I had added to this calendar an event handler for when the date is changed, where a message is shown with the new selected date. So of course that event handler assigned to controls embedded in the grid will just continue to work as is. So any type of control you can actually add to the grid cells and continue to interact with it, deal with the event handlers, etc. And then let's move to the last column of the grid, where we have added the button to insert a subgrid and detail grid, as you want to name it. When I click here the button and we switch to the code, you can see here that a grid is added, and that automatically creates a second instance of a grid to add it in a cell, and we can continue to interact with that grid as an FNC data grid. And so we can call this load sample data method that is standard provided on the data grid to add this data in our grid. And in that grid, you could again, for example, insert controls, HTML formatted text, images, and so on. It is a data grid in a data grid, so you can continue to work with it with all its aspects and features and capabilities as a data grid. And this is how you can just interact with the subgrid in the main grid here, the data grid. And so with that, I gave you an overview of the many types of cells that are available in the FNC data grid, how you can add these at cell level or at column level, how you can interact with it, how you can deal with bitmap containers and also subgrids. I think you have with the data grid a lot really a lot of power in your hands. Source code of this demo you can find under this video. Click the link for it. And don't forget, of course, subscribe on this video series so you are surely informed when we have the next FNC Data Grid video ready for you. Thank you for watching.